Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. My name is the Prince of FNAF, and if you're new here, please consider subscribing. And of course, if you like the content seen in tonight's video, then be sure to hit that notification bell and like button. That way, you will indeed be notified for any awesome videos like this in the future. With that out of the way, let's get started with today's video. Kong Skull Island is a 2017 kaiju monsterverse film starring Tom Hiddleston, Samuel L. Jackson, John Goodman, Brie Larson, and John C. Reilly. It is the second installment in Warner Bros. And Legendary Pictures' Monsterverse. So this movie opens up much the same way Godzilla's movie opens up, in the sense that you have some grainy footage that's being displayed in front of you. Now, the interesting thing about the way they did it here is it takes place during the Vietnam War. You have things like sending the man up to the moon. You have things like the protests and the political stuff that was happening at that time. And of course, at the center of it is the Vietnam War and how it's actually ravaged their society. And so John Goodman's character gets out of a taxi during all of this chaos that's happening, and basically he walks up to an office to talk to his friend who's in the higher ups about getting a helicopter transport to a uncharted island that they've discovered called Skull Island. It's a very dark place covered in lots of mystery, and so obviously their friend says it's a fairy tale, it doesn't exist. And they're like, well, come on, like, wouldn't you rather have us discovered it first so we can get resources? And we're even going to be going into this island to do a survey. We can actually test the ground to see if it's hollow. And basically a whole standpoint of the movie is that one of the characters actually wrote a paper that talks about a hollow earth and how there's this empty space in the earth where a lot of these monsters that have been showing up have been originating from. It's this whole forgotten ecosystem. So of course they eventually talk the guy into giving them a helicopter transport, and so the guy reaches out to Samuel Jackson, who is Colonel Packard in the movie, and basically they and his team of army men, his mercenaries, they all go gather up, set up shop. They basically tell the people what they're going to do. They're going to go to the island, do a seismic survey, they're going to drop bombs, and basically they're going to try to see the seismic readings to see if the island is actually hollow and if this is an entry point to the supposed hollow earth. So they eventually end up at Skull Island as they break through the massive storm that surrounds the island, and they finally get to Skull Island and they start dropping bombs, and eventually this angers the god of the island, King Kong, as King Kong violently and angrily destroys and downs all helicopters in the area. This of course angers Colonel Packard, who throughout the rest of the movie starts going mad with power and starts going insane with this fantasy that Kong is actually an enemy and wants to basically destroy everything he's worked so hard to achieve in his life. So throughout the course of the movie, you slowly start to see Samuel Jackson's character go from being a very respectable man to slowly start becoming more insane as the movie progresses, with his need to want to kill Kong for killing his men. As the movie goes along, we start to see the other creatures that exist on the island, and not all of them are peaceful. Some of the other creatures that exist on the island are the Skull Crawlers, these reptilian-type creatures who basically destroy King Kong's entire bloodline. Kong is the only one left. And so Kong, when these creatures surface on the island, they come up from the hollow earth in the ventilation of the island, Kong beats the shit out of them and drives the rest of them back into the hollow earth. And he's done this for many years. But when these people came to the island and started dropping their seismic charges, it pissed Kong off because it woke up a bunch of them and they started surfacing. As the movie goes on, we learn more about the island's history and how the Iwi's people believe that Kong is a protector, he is God, and he's worshipped like one on the island. However, the Skull Crawlers are referred to as the Devils. They live underneath the island, and Kong has to protect the people of this island from the Skull Crawlers, as they are very territorial and very aggressive. As the movie goes on, we also even learn that there is a huge skull crawler that took out Kong's entire family called Ramorak. This giant skull crawler is the whole premise of the movie, and they're like, you don't want to use any more of those charges because if you wake this one up, the big one comes up, Kong goes down, and it's goodnight, Irene. So basically that inevitably happens. Kong figures out a way to fight Ramorak, defeat it, and basically save the day with the help of the humans. They go back to civilization, and that's the end. Now, the movie is well written. I do like it. Brie Larson was actually really fun to watch in this movie, and I did like it. John C. Reilly was funny. I like how they turned him into this kind of guy who got stuck on the island, and now he's kind of cuckoo insane, and it's really good. I liked Tom Hiddleston. He was good in this movie. I mean, he's good in every movie. I say that altogether, this was a really good movie, and I did enjoy it. I love the kind of more beast-like Kong in his glory, you know, because in all the other movies, he kind of was this monster that was just inevitably killed. But no, it was a happy ending for King Kong in this movie, and he was just thriving in this world in which he was king. Anyway, I think this is a great movie. Like I said before, with Godzilla, you should definitely check it out. It's one of the best King Kong movies ever. With that being said, do take care, have a great night, and I'll see you guys in the video.